In this video, we're going to look at how to find the area of a trapezium. So here we've got a trapezium, and a trapezium is a quadrilateral with one pair of parallel sides. And I have labeled some of the key measurements that are going to help us find the area. And they are A and B, the two parallel sides, and H, which is the height of the trapezium, which is also the distance between the two parallel sides. And the area of a trapezium is given by the formula, a half, bracket, A plus B, close brackets, times by the height. In other words, you add together the lengths of the two parallel sides, you half that, and then times by the height, and that gives you the area of a trapezium. This formula is very important to learn, okay? So I'd recommend you learn this off by heart. Okay, let's have a look at some examples. So here we've got a trapezium, and just to help us remember, here's the formula, okay? And let's label the sides. So A and B are the two parallel sides, A and B, and the height is the distance between them, which is 4. So A is 5, B is 7, and H is 4. So using the formula, the area equals a half. The two parallel sides added together, the lengths of them added together, so that's going to be 5 plus 7. And then we're going to times that by H, the distance between them, so that's 4. Okay, so using Bodmas, we're going to work out the 5 plus 7 first of all. So 5 plus 7 is 12. And then still timesing that by 4, and still we're going to half it. And now what we're going to do is, now we could half the 12 and times by 4, or we could do the 12 times the 4 and then half it. Both of them will give you the same answer. Just in this case, I'm going to half the 12. So half of 12 is 6 times by 4 is equal to 24. So the area of this trapezium is 24 centimeters squared. Okay, next example. Okay, this time we've got a trapezium that has got two right angles. So you'll see that the A and the B, the two parallel sides, are the 9 and the 10. The H this time, it would be the distance between them, which is this side here, okay? Because if it's two right angles, the length of the side will also be the height of the trapezium as well. Okay, so we're just going to put those into the formula. So the area equals a half of the two parallel sides added together. So A is 9 and B is 10. And we're going to times that by the height between them, the height of the trapezium, which is 8. Again, we're going to do 9 plus 10, which is 19. And then we're going to times that by 8 still and half it. Now again, we could half the 19 and times by 8, or we could do the 19 times 8 and then half it. I'm going to half it first of all, which is 9.5, and then times by 8, which will give me 76 centimeters squared. And that's the area of that trapezium. And our last example. Now this example is just slightly different because I have rotated the trapezium 90 degrees. So as you can see, it's on its side. If you want to look at it the normal way around, you can turn the page. If it's on a test paper, you can turn the test paper around to look like, you know, the way I've had my last two examples, or you could just turn your head. But again, I'm just going to label the sides. A and B are the two parallel sides, and H is the distance between them, or the height of the trapezium. So the distance between the two parallel sides is 2. So the area equals a half of A plus B, so that's 2.5 plus 3.3. And then we're going to times that by the distance between them, or the height of it, which is 2. So that's going to be a half of 2.5 plus 3.3 is 5.8. And then we're going to times that by 2. Again, we can do 5.8 times 2 and then half it, or half of the 5.8, which is 2.9, and times by 2, which is equal to 5.8 millimeters squared. And that's it. And that's the area of that trapezium, 5.8 millimeters squared. And again, make sure you're careful with the units.